Yes, good morning students. Today we are going to start the next topic of our chapter, role of government in health. So earlier we discussed about that what is health. When we talk, when a person's body is free from, you know, any illness or any injury, we call that person a healthy person. So health came under the two category. One is, you know, physical, and second one is psychological. If a person is physically and psychologically both, you know, in both aspect he is fine, then we call that a person a healthy person. Then we discuss about different healthcare facilities which are provided by our government for all the citizens of the India. As we all know that we all live in a democratic country. So in a democratic country, the responsibility of government is to provide health facilities for all the citizens. So different health facilities are provided by the government, as there are many hospitals opened by the government which provide facilities for the benefit of all the citizens. So here is an example of a story, Hakim Sheikh, in your books. So Hakim Sheikh was, you know, a member of Pashchim Bengal organization Khet Mazdoor Samiti. He was a member of this samiti. The main this samiti belongs to a members who belong to a agricultural labor class. So what happened that in 1992 he fell off a running rail and suffered head injuries. So he got a head injury in 1992 when accidentally he fell off from the train. So at that time he needed a, you know, a very you know, fast treatment at that time. So he went to a hospital in, you know, Kolkata, but that government hospital refused to admit him. The reason behind was that they don't have, you know, spare bed. So he visited another hospital for, you know, getting treatment, but that hospital also refused to admit him because they don't have a special services for his treatment. So he was refused to admitted in 8 hospitals, and during this his condition was, you know, deteriorating very, you know, fast. So after having a 14 hours of this problem, he was admitted to a private hospital where he has to pay a lot of money. So he and his members from this samiti filed a case against the government because he felt that it was the responsibility of government to provide him the treatment which he was needed at that time, but government was unable to provide him the treatment. That's why he filed a case against the government so that he will get, you know, the benefit which he was supposed to be given from the government. So this was the story about Hakim Sheikh, who was, you know, not admitted in the government hospital. So the government was unable to provide him the facilities which he was, you know, promised him. As our constitution promised us that the basic responsibility of government is to provide all the health and education services for us, but in this case the government was unable to provide the facility which Hakim Sheikh was supposed to be given. Yes students, so the next topic of this chapter is why do we pay taxes? As we all know that we all you know, supposed to pay tax to the government. Either we belongs to an individual community. If we are individual community, we have to pay an income tax. And if we are, you know, doing some business activity at that time, we also have to pay tax to the government. So what is the reason behind of paying tax to the government? So the main reason behind paying tax to the government is that government provide facilities and benefits in return. If the government, you know, take taxes from us, so in return government provide us some facilities and benefits. So what are the different facilities which are provided by the government in return of our taxes? Some you know, facilities are like development programs. Development programs include, you know, construction of roads, government hospitals, government schools. So these are the services which are provided by the government for the purpose of development. Then facility of police. As we all know that law and order is maintained with the help of a police. So these services also provided by the government. Then defense, it includes our army. So the different things which are required for the defense is also, you know, provided by the government. And then, you know, some judicial system, courts, as we all know that if we want to get, you know, rebate or if we want to get any verdict for this, we all have to go to court for the solution of our problems. Our, you know, our problems resolve in the court. So this facility is also provided by the government. And at the time of, you know, koi natural disaster like earthquake happened, at that time the relief and rehabilitation is also provided by the government. So, you know, people are shifted from one place to another due to this natural disaster. So all these services are provided by the government when we pay tax to the government. As these services and these, you know, benefits and services are not created by citizens themselves, that's why we have to pay tax to the government, so that government collect the amount from the tax and provide us services and benefits. So these are the main reasons behind paying tax to the government. Yes, students, as there are two type of health services which are provided in our country. The first health service is public health service, and the second health service is private health service. So from the name of this public health service, it means these are the services which are provided to the public by the government. So these health services are provided by the government. Their services are for all citizens, either free or at low cost, and mainly found in rural area. This type of services provided by the government is mainly found in the rural areas, and they do not have, you know, advanced facilities. The services which are provided by the government does not have advanced facilities, as maybe due to the problem of insufficient funds, or maybe due to the problem of, you know, the area in which the hospitals are set up. So these are the different things, yeah, different features we offer public health services. And when we talk about the private health services, these services are run or controlled by the private individuals. They also provide benefits and services for all citizens, but for availing the service of a private health service, we all have to pay a lot of money. As they have advanced, you know, machines like ultrasound for x-rays, for you know, blood tests. They have different modern equipments that public health services does not have. And there is, you know, we have a data that said that only 20% of our population, 20% of our population can avail private health services. Only 20%. Why? The reason behind this is that they provide services at a very high cost. So it is very difficult for those who belongs to a middle class family or from a poor class family. They, you know, do not use the services, the beautiful and modern services which are provided by the private health service. So only 20% population is there. Rest 80% population is not able to use the private health services. But if they want to use the private health services, like 20% can use the service and rest 80% is unable to use this service. So another, we have, you know, data that if 40% of population who is using this private health service, but for using this private health service, either they have to borrow loan, or sell off their possessions. Maybe they have to, you know, sold their car, their houses, so that they can avail the service of private health services. So these are the main health services which are provided in our country, India. As we came to know that private health services are providing better facilities as compared to public health services. The reason behind this that they have modern equipments, modern services which a public health service does not have. So these are the two health services that are found in our India. So after, you know, discussing about the different health services which are provided in our India, so we came to know that private health services have better, you know, equipment as compared to the public health services. So what can be done? What preventive measures the government should take so that the condition of health facilities became, you know, good in the country, so that every citizen, you know, if they want to use the health services, they does not have to borrow money, and you know, this condition does not arise that for availing any service they have to sell off their possession. So this is the responsibility of government, that the government should provide, you know, facilities for the benefit of a people in a very, you know, low cost. If the government will provide this facility in a very low cost and quality service in a low cost, at that time we all, there is no need that people will shift for getting their services, they have to move to the urban areas or in private hospitals. So we have two examples in our, you know, chapter that discuss about that what different things that our India can also do so that, you know, this problem of health related problems can be solved. So here we discuss about the two examples that we have in this chapter. So we have a first example of a Kerala. What does the state of a Kerala do? In 1996, the Kerala government decided to make some changes. So what changes they have done? They have given 40% of budget to the panchayats. They have given the budget for healthcare facilities. They have, what they did? Yes, what was the reason behind giving 40% budget to the panchayat? The Kerala government, what does the Kerala government do? The Kerala government decentralized its powers and gave the power to the panchayat, that now this is the responsibility of panchayat, is providing, you know, facilities to the local people, like providing, you know, good water conditions, providing, you know, a healthy area, you know, good environment, and, you know, also responsible for the education and development for the women. So what does the Kerala do? Kerala plays a very important role. He decentralized his power and given a power to the panchayat or at a local level, so that the main issues of a local people are to be solved by the panchayats. Like if there is a problem of, you know, drinking water, if there will be no clean drinking water, then who will be there who will provide this, you know, facility for them? So panchayats are there who will provide the facility to the local people. So for this reason, for, you know, solving all the problem, what does the Kerala state do? The Kerala state, you know, give 40% budget to the panchayat. For example, if a Kerala has a total budget of 100 crore rupees, they have given 40 crore rupees to the panchayat, so that, you know, panchayat can solve the problems at local level. So this was the first example of Kerala. Then the second example is the Kasa Rican. The second example is the Costa Rican approach. So this is a in the Costa Rican approach. Yes, so Costa Rican is a country in the Central America. As you can say, it is a North America and then South America. Between the North America and South America, it is in Central America. So Costa Rican is a country in which in a Central America. So this country is known to be the healthiest country in the Central America. So what is the reason behind that this country is said to be a healthiest country? According to a, you know, Costa Rican constitution, they have decided that they don't want an army. They have decided that they don't want to have an army. So they save the money that can be used for making an army and used that amount for the benefit of health, education and need of the people. That's why they have used a lot of money for the benefit of people regarding their health related problem, their education problem. So that's why this country is known to be the healthiest country in Central America. So we have, you know, experienced two examples that in Kerala, the Kerala also decided to improve the health facilities by providing a budget at a local level, or, you know, distributing its power so that the local authorities can take decision about the different problems that are faced by the local people. Same we have discussed in the Costa Rican, that in Costa Rican country, they have decided that they don't want an army, and they saved the money which could be used for the formation of army, and they use that money for the benefits of the people. Either the benefit is for health, either the benefit is for education and other benefits. So all these examples help our India to understand this concept that for having a better healthcare facilities for all the local people, government should take preventive measures so that there will be no problem faced by the local people that, you know, they have to borrow money for getting a health facility. So with the help of these examples, we came to know about that there are different measures that can be taken, as same the measure taken by the Kerala. Other states can also take these steps so that, you know, the problem faced by the local people related to education or health can be solved. Thanks. This was all about the chapter of role of government in the health. We came to know about the different aspects of healthcare facilities which are provided by the government, as well the facilities which are provided by the private healthcare services. Thank you and have a nice day.